Hey guys, it's Sejal. I actually got thinking today. I used to say hi guys in my older videos, but now I say hey guys, and someone pointed that out to me today. So today is all about taking your own photos at home without anybody's help, so to say self-portraits. This is something that I really, really like doing. I've been doing this pretty much all throughout since I started my YouTube channel. It's a really, really fun and creative process. And especially if you are a content creator or if you just need great photos to put up on Instagram, Facebook, Tinder. Also, the short film that I did, Half of My Heart with Terribly Tiny Talkie, that also we shot on our own, at home, with just our phones. I'm gonna share with you some really fun, creative, easy hacks that you can use to get amazing photos of yourself without taking anybody else's help. So let's get started. So number one is the equipment. Camera I use to shoot most of my videos, and for a lot of my photos as well is this DSLR that this video is getting recorded on at the moment. It's the Sony A7 Mark II. It's a really old camera. I don't think it's even available anymore. And I use it with a 50mm lens. This, in very, very basic terminology, is that lens that gives you that super blurry background and mostly is used for portrait pictures, but I use it for all kinds of shots. I only have this lens, and whatever videos you've seen on my channel that are shot using my camera have been shot on this lens. If you don't have a DSLR, that's okay, because I wanted to make this video using specifically phones. Most people these days have really good cameras on their phones as well. And I recently got the iPhone 11. This is the one with the three cameras. So there's a portrait one, there's a normal one, and there's a super wide lens on this also. And this has really, really good picture quality. I used to have the Google Pixel 3XL before this, which also had really, really great picture quality, and I flicked so many amazing photos on that as well. Next thing that I feel is really, really great if you have this is a tripod for your phone. This is one that I have, which has these squiggly legs, so you can bend them, but I don't particularly like bending them. It has an attachment for your phone. This is a really sturdy one, which I recommend, because you don't want to damage your phone with a sasta, bura quality tripod. Then I have just this attachment. This is a really, really good one. So it has screws on it, and it opens up in a really nice way, and it has padding on the side so that when you attach your phone doesn't get scratched, which is really important. This is, I think, worth 350 rupees on Amazon, but to damage your phone, it's not worth buying a cheap tripod. But also, if you don't have a tripod, I recently just got this since I came back to Delhi, because I didn't have any equipment with me. In fact, Half of My Heart was also shot. Books rakke and then kuch ajeeb tarah ke jugaad angle karke, so that's also possible. But if you get this, it really, really will change your life, because you can play with different angles very easily. Last thing for really great photos is light. Today we'll be shooting most of our photos outside with sunlight, but if you have that extra budget, you can also get a ring light. I bought my first ever ring light this week, so it's really great for those close-up mid-shot photos, and then it adds that ring in your eyes, which looks really nice, and it illuminates your face really well. Especially if you're shooting pictures with makeup and if you want to show off all the colors on your face, a ring light is very good for that. That we'll be shooting today is to use the back camera of your phone. I know it can get a little annoying, so sometimes I just end up using the front camera only, but if you use the back camera, you'll get better quality. And to shoot in sunlight, so phones these days have amazing picture quality, but still they still don't work really, really good in low light, in my opinion. Phone like iPhone, it just does something amazing with sunlight for your skin, so I would totally recommend that. Number two is your outfit and your makeup. This is really, really important to get that, you know, extra oomph out of your picture. And of course, that is also an element of creativity that you're adding in your picture. And I feel like I'm really, really good at matching which outfit looks good with which location. The first would be to use an outfit which is completely contrasting in color from your location. So say if I'm wearing a yellow outfit, I'll try and shoot it opposite a blue background or a purple background so that those colors really stand out. Another thing that I do is to match the colors completely. Look very artistic and professional. So say if I'm wearing denim, I will try and find a blue background completely, so those two colors look really great together. Or say if I'm wearing white, I'll try and shoot it in front of a completely white background. And another interesting thing you can do is have your outfit be completely opposite of the vibe of the location. Say you shoot like this really nice pantsuit in Chandni Chowk. So in the close-ups, you can do different things with your eyes. I recently ordered these really crazy green lenses, which I'm gonna try and wear in this video as well. That is it for my initial tips. Now we will get started with taking our photos.
The first picture we're gonna take is using leaves, and we're gonna use foregrounding. So I am still in my room, and we have these pattas that we're gonna use, these plants, and this one also. I think leaves and plants just look beautiful in a picture. And the really nice mobile attachment that I have attached it onto my Chota tripod. Since it'll be easier to shoot with this. All the lights in the room are off. We only have this source of light, which is from the side. So, and here's my phone. Let's get shooting. Wearing bright orange because it contrasts completely with the green and the white, so I think it'll really pop. Started
with adjusting the plants and the flowers around me to be in a position that I'm kind of in between the flowers so that it looks like I'm covered with them. That look looks best for these kind of photos. And then I was just playing around with my poses, trying different things with my hands. When you're alone, you don't have to be shy. Then I also picked up one of the flowers and used it as a prop, and then also used it in the foreground. So basically put my hand away from the camera, but just put the flower in the camera so that there's a little bit of white showing up in your frame, and that looks really nice, especially when it gets blurred out. Then I just spent a little bit more time experimenting with more poses, more angles, hands in front, hand at the back, and these are my final photos after editing. I think they look really great.
So hack number two that we're gonna try is a really popular one, which is the creating a spotlight from a torch. For this you need a spare phone, you need some tape like doctor's tape, and you need a toilet paper roll. This is my Google Pixel 3 XL that I love. You abhi bhi iska screen unfortunately puri tarah shatter ho gaya hai. Iski battery bhi gayi kya? Oh my god.
So I decided to show you how to put the tape. So I just put it on my iPhone. This was really painful. So basically you take a long piece of tape, put it on your toilet roll, and then wrap it all the way around so it has to go on your screen, and then do the same thing laterally as well.
Since this is a dark look, I wanted my look to be slightly sexier, so I'm wearing this tiny crop top, and I tied my hair up. So
where you can shoot this is somewhere where you can shut the curtains and make your room really dark, or of course you shoot this at night. The torch running on this other phone, and I'm gonna take pictures with this phone. Yay, this looks really really good. So maine ek light on chhod rakhi hai, which is the bathroom light, so that there's some light falling on my face.
Look at how cool that looks.
As for the settings, I started off with my front camera on this, and I'm using the normal photo mode. I switch between portrait and photo for each of these setups depending on what is looking nicer, but I try both always. So in this, I'm just playing around with different poses, different angles, different sides. And then I wasn't too happy with the front camera because yahan pe light bahut low hai. So if it's the back camera, the quality would be better, but then I was not in frame most of the time. So I just decided that screw it, let's just use the front camera. And then again, playing with a million different kinds poses, smiling, not smiling, hand on your hair, and then again I tried playing with shadows with the plant. Leaf shadows look amazing, so I tried to angle the leaf in a way so that the shadows fall perfectly on my face, and this is the final result.
And the reason I've covered my eyes and shut them now is because I recently got green contact lenses, and I am warning you guys, you will be alarmed a little bit, but I think it looks really good. All my friends are calling me Billy, but I think it looks pretty good. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Oh my god, looks so different. Right, so the next thing that I want to talk about are background. What I used to really really like doing, especially when I was back in Mumbai, was sticking chart papers to the wall. Add a plant in front of it, and it would give a very nice like studio shoot kind of look. I don't have a chart paper with me, and nor can I go to a stationery shop to get it. So this idea actually I got off a really really nice channel that I found recently. So credit and shout out goes out to her. I really wanted to try out using dupattas, shawls, saris as a background on the wall. So I'm wearing all Indian since I'm going to be using my mom's 2 dupattas on the wall. So I picked up this red one, which I'm going to try and show the most. So pink and red, again, it's in the same color scheme, so I think it'll work really well. And I also have this yellow. So we'll see, we'll show a little peek of it to add like a little bit of contrast as well. We have the same tape, so let's stick this on the wall. So I'm gonna stick it on this wall, and the light is coming straight from the front. So the light is gonna be really nice and even when it comes on our background. That looks so good. I'm so excited about it. And also the great part is that some of the fabric is also coming down on the floor like that. So it'll look like a really nice studio kind of effect once I start shooting.
This setup was actually really easy to do. Again, I'm using the front camera on the regular photo setting here. And then I was sitting and it opened twice. So that was quite funny, but it was easy to attach back. So again, I tried different poses. I was mostly sitting in this one. I wanted to get the lower part of the setup as well so that it looks like it extends till the floor. And then I tried leaning, hands on my shoulders, hands on my knees, everything. And I also took some standing shots. I wanted to get one in which my lehenga is flying, so I had to do a million different variations of it, and I also tried shooting in the white setting. And yeah, I'm going at it, and this is the final result.
I'm back outside in my balcony because I wanted to shoot against the sky. Sky is genuinely one of the best backgrounds you will ever find. It always looks beautiful and it always keeps changing, and also you can play around with the color of the sky a lot on the edit. I'm going to place my phone on the ground and trying to get some extremely low angle shots. And in this balcony, the only scope I have to get the sky is to shoot from here.
The tricky thing with this is that the camera would automatically either choose to make you bright or the sky bright, but that was happening when the photo came out, the sky was also equally well lit. So I just had to try it like 10-15 different times to get one perfect photo where my lehenga is also flying and the sky was also blue. And after a little bit of editing, this is what I got.
The last hack that I want to experiment with is colored lighting. I got obsessed with this when I basically decorated my room colored disco type lighting using cellophane paper on the lights above, and then I started using it on all my shoots. I have one LED light in Bombay, so I would put any kind of cellophane paper on it and it would give a really nice colored light effect. But since I don't have cellophane paper nor do I have that LED light here, a really cool hack that I found while shooting my three crazy characters thoughts everyone has during the lockdown video is
that you can use
a good old dupatta and put it on any light that you have in your house. Obviously, look for something through which light can pass, and also at the same time that wo zyada bhi patla na ho ki red light bilkul bhi bahar na aaye. I knew the light would be like red and it'll be kind of moody and yet kind of disco theme. That's what I had in my head. That's why I put some white eyeliner on top of my black one, and I also wore this white shirt so that it gives this kind of vintage effect.
So for this one, I wanted to try a different position. So I tried to set up my tripod in front on the bed, then I just came back to the front again, and this time I set up a slightly lower angle. Usually for close-up shots of my face, I try and do a higher angle because I feel like it suits your face a little bit more. But this one, since it's a mid shot, I set it up a little lower. And in this one, I'm just using the back camera because the light is really low in the setup and we need good quality. And it took a few different tries to make sure that I'm in frame, but it was worth it. And then I took some front camera shots also, but I prefer the back camera ones. Alright guys, so that was it for today's video. Hope you found this helpful and creative and just fun to watch. I love watching these kind of videos. I would really like to see what you guys create looking at these tips and tricks. So you can tag me in your pictures on Instagram, tag me in your stories, and do subscribe. Let's get the channel up to 1.5 million really soon. I used to do these milestone things so long ago and I completely stopped doing them. But yes, let us get to 1.5 million really soon. And I hope you guys enjoy it. I'll see you soon.